First of all, I do not have actual video of me racing on the street. Are you kidding? I'm not putting that on here. But if you want to hear the story, keep watching.
What is up? Welcome back to the channel. Don't worry, we got some cool car updates coming up. I'm not going to tell you what they are, just in case they don't happen. But it's coming, I hope. So yeah, hold and patch. I've got to cover my company logo. Can't be broadcasting that all the time on this channel. So yeah, I got beat by a bike, a motorcycle to be specific here. It was a sport bike. I wasn't surprised. I expected to get beat. The horsepower to weight ratio on those are no joke. It wasn't a really long race, and we were in Mexico when this happened. He literally rolled up to me. My windows were down, and he looked over. He said, you know, he motioned to me like we're gonna go on three. I just kind of laughed and said, okay, sure, why not? I'll entertain you. I know you're gonna smoke me. So, but you know, see what happens. He does the 1, 2, 3, and we both hit it. I think it was a 40. Yeah, it was a 40 roll, and he was gone. I think we were neck and neck for about half a second, and then he just took off. Now there was plenty of traffic, so we didn't even do an eighth of a mile run. I mean, it was a quick go. I'm not gonna say how fast we topped out at, but by the time I had to slow down, he was long gone. I never saw him again. So the reason I'm got you guys here with me today is somebody asked me, Armin, how did you even get into cars? That was actually hard for me to answer. My first fun car would have to be the Dodge Neon SRT4, a 2004 model. I was telling somebody just recently how I still love that car. It was a fun car to drive. I did the Stage 1 Mopar upgrade. I did sway bars front and back. I also put braces in the front and the back. Also tightened that suspension. I also put a short shifter in it too. I want to say that's probably my first fun car. So that's been, 15 years ago now? But I will have to say that's probably the first time I really got into cars. And my journey started from there. Somebody asked me that the other day too. What is Armin's dream car? Gosh, that's a tough one. Because I love all kinds of cars. See, for me, it's not about owning a car, it's about driving a car. And there's a lot of cars I'd love to drive today. But I'd love, on my bucket list, I gotta drive a Ferrari. I gotta scratch that off my bucket list. I don't care if it's an older Ferrari, like a Ferrari 328, or a newer Ferrari. I'd be more than happy to do that too. But I really need to experience a Ferrari with a true Ferrari sound. I kind of prefer an older Ferrari because I want that gated shifter driving experience. Of course, if a newer Ferrari dropped in my lap, I'd definitely take that for a spin, no question there. But if I were to pick a Ferrari, it's got to be an older one with a gated shifter. I gotta get that driving experience. And I would probably choose a Ferrari Testarossa from the 80s. An 84, 85, 86, 87. One, any of those model years, I'd be fine driving and knock it off my bucket list. It was an 80s type of car that really just spoke to that decade. And it was when I was in high school, and I just loved that car. So I would totally love to drive one day and get that off the bucket list. Anybody here driven a Testarossa before? Leave a comment below, let me know what you think. I've heard it's not the greatest Ferrari to drive in terms of handling and stuff. It's not the most powerful, but it was part of that 80s. It was an 80s icon of a car in terms of image and style and excess and, you know, American greed. It was just, and I was a kid in high school. I mean, I was easily influenced by that at the time. I'd love to drive one. So what's your dream car? Leave a comment below. Thanks again for tuning in and checking in. I'll see you guys next time. Take care.